Today I'm gonna work on the Markdown Marquee Editor again. And in today's session, I want to clean up the prototype a little bit that I previously implemented. The next thing I want to do today is to attempt to fix the italic output. In the last session, the both underscores were rendered within the HTML output. So there I need to fix this somehow. And if I can make it so far in today's session, I have a stretch goal. Maybe I can try to start prototyping safe with HTML5 file system API. Let's see if we can make it so far. Let's check the current status. This is how it looks like right now. So, and if I type something in, that works right now. The output is currently only in console. And let's test all the fields. Maybe we just don't have to fix the italic. Maybe also some other things are not working as expected. The bold seems to work. Oh no, it's still bold. We need to click italic here. Italic also seems to work. Weird. Last time it didn't. Let's check underlined. That works too. Next thing we need to check is a list. That works too. The unordered list seems to work too. Sub. No, that doesn't work. Well, let's see, maybe. Oh yes, it also works. And this also works. Here we have headings. Let's test those too. What we don't have, yeah, we need to check the images as well. So we have a headline one. This is, yeah, we need to unchoose that. So, yeah, seems to work as expected. Maybe only a restart was necessary from the last session. But it's okay. We don't need to do what is already working. Good, H5. And we have the normal should be a P. Paragraph text. So, we can center it. That works here, but we don't have any class output for that. That's not what we want, actually. We need to check for this. Maybe this needs to be implemented. I will take a quick note. There's no class name applied when selecting text layout. So maybe we need to fix that. Let's check a link. I want to have the left aligned. So for now. So HTTP. example.com renders a link. Let's test an image. So for now we take a picture of me. Zack, there we go. A little big. I need Let's test another image. Yes, that works. Great. Video. Okay, we need to take an embed URL. I don't have something in hand. I just assume that it works. What is this? I don't know what this even is. Whoop! What was this? Is this... Ah, that's clearing. That's clearing all the styles. Okay. Looks good. Let's go. So we don't need the option to disable bolt. I'm not interested in this. Let's check if we have this somewhere. Ah, okay, yeah, we don't want this. So, and yeah, we don't need this. So everyone wants to have bolt. So we have an error somewhere we are using. Yeah, not necessary. All of this. We don't need this. So, and also this is not necessary. Good. The start time is also not necessary. It's just from the code we've copied. So placeholder, yeah, placeholder. We will need a placeholder. The whole use effect is not necessary. The reset might be. Let's see. Yeah, but that's a different feature. Okay, the time passed is definitely not necessary. And seems that we don't use the need the use effect. And I guess the whole thing could be its own component. Let's do that. Let's call this editor. And we are going to move all of this into the editor.js. So, and let's refactor this and let's call this editor. Yes. Looks good. So, and here we are only importing the editor. We don't need all of this right now. Maybe we give it a main tag and we are using the editor here for now. So that's what I want to do. Yes. Let's see if this still works. Can't resolve app CSS, yeah, because we don't have any CSS, we don't need this here. So and yes, this is how it should look like. I want to check the responsive behavior. Oh, that's cool. Fully responsive already. Nice. So it would be easy to just divide this into three parts. One for the file tree later. The other one is for the editor. And you might be able to put also the preview on the right side. That's the plan. Good. Okay. So next thing would be, yeah, let me check the README. There's no class name applied when selecting text layout. I want to look and check what we've got here. Let me mark this. This is, we need to lock the content actually. So this is the original content being passed from Quill.js. I like the song. And we have the passed markdown result in HTML. So let's check what we get here. Passed markdown result. So, and what I want to see is this. Okay, it has a class align center. And we are losing this completely. Let's see in which state. So let's have a look what a raw markdown looks like. Raw markdown is only SD without. Let's check the documentation from to markdown. If we can do something about that, otherwise we have to think about that. No, that's not what I'm looking for. Okay, will be. I didn't saw that there. That's not done yet. A converter object consists of a filter and a replacement. This sample from the source code replaces code elements. Okay, but it doesn't say anything about oh nice. Let's check if we have better results if we try to use GitHub flavored markdown. No, not really, but this is because we have classes there. Seems that we okay, if I understood this correctly, we can just put the converter here, and this is an array, and we want one converter for yeah, let's put this in a different folder. Let's call this filters, and I want to have named text layout filter. So, and we are exporting export default. Ah, no, let's first what are the arguments for this function? If we want to have... Ah, okay, we can also pass in the node. Then we will pass in the node. And for now, we will only return the node. This is filter function and replacement function. Okay. So that means we can actually just, yeah, we can return an object with the filter and with the replacement. So the replacement will be also a function in a HTML and node. So const replace text layout class. What I actually want is that it's not being replaced at all, because we want to keep this. What we can do is actually to put an inline style there. Yeah. I think we should do it like that for now. Maybe we'll be going to change it later. So at the moment we have this for every So. Node name, if it is P, is this, yeah, I think. Node class list contains yeah, that's actually could be a couple of things. So we need to check what it contains. For now I put here blah and in a replacement I will just return for now I will change nothing that I can check it properly. So let's check. QL Align Center. So, or what else can it contain? That applies nothing, right? No, the result, okay. What else do we have? We have right. QL align right. So then we put an OR case here. And we have one last thing that is something like justify. Query line justify. Good. So let's check if this works already. So if it works, if we register this here. Should name this converter. Okay. That's the text layout converter. So let's import this. Text layout converter. Perfect. And we want to use it. Let's see if it works. So seems to work. And if it is normal, it shouldn't be there. Okay, awesome. Works exactly as I wanted. So we have the line justify and we want to have back in a raw markdown output. We want to have the P inside of it. Yeah, let's do that. So exactly. So what we want to get, let's put this in backticks. that's a variable should keep exactly the output. Ah, no. What we want here is let me check the HTML first. So what do we have here? There's nothing, and when we align it center, raw markdown is really a P. Okay. So let me check how I can achieve text layout justify. I don't know the CSS justify text. Text justify property. Text line justify. Okay, this is how it works. Good. Then let's create another object here. Let's call this woods. And let's use those things here as an identifier. This should be I don't want a break within this. Good. Do I have the... I have the note here. So... can also do it like that. Makes no sense because we already secured this with the filter, but just in case something in Quill.js is going updated, I just want to make this work here. So we return just the inner HTML for now. So, but if we have something inside of it. So for this mode equals rules. We can just write it like this. Looks better. Saves space. So it's if, as we cannot have both, we have the mode is what's right, and the last rule would be justify. Oops. So mode justify. So, and if we don't have a mode, we just return the inner HTML, and if we have it, then we will apply the mode. So, that looks great, my perspective. One last thing, let's fix the formatting here, and I don't like it that we repeat the class names. Send the class name so like this, and also for the right class name. And justify class name. Good, then let's replace this accordingly. And here. And last thing here. So now let's check our output. Awesome. So maybe we should already try this out. So we can remove the console logs for now. I think everything is working as expected. Oops. Yeah, we are not doing anything with the markdown. What are we doing with this value? Where does this come from? Value. Ah, yeah, okay. Okay, then we leave it as it is. And the set placeholder can also stay for now. But we should do something with the outcome. I think we should pass it through through a pop function. So then let's pass it through the props. So let's call this function handle editor change. So and we get a value, and this value we will save this within a state. Well, let's call it actually we can. So. So for now we will just, as we don't have the output now and it's not, shouldn't be part of this session, we will just set here, just display the output. Let's do it like that. We will use the HTML, therefore we need to put it here and it needs to be this content. So, and we need to pass this prop. How do I type props in plain vanilla JavaScript? In React, type prop types, type props in React. I forgot about this. Normally, prop types. Okay. I think this is part of the standard. Okay, prop types. So, and editor prop types. Should be, how to name this child? That's on editor change, yes. On editor change is prop types function. No. Not like this. Prop type func. Yeah. And that's mandatory. So, and here we are going to destructure the props. What's the name? On editor change. On editor change equals props. And we want to pass the result up to its parent like this. So last thing we need to do is to on editor change handle editor change. That should be it. Let's check. Works as expected. No, I want to check this. That also works. That works. That works. Nice. Okay. Good. So I think we are through this. Now to the hard part. We want to somehow save what we are receiving here. I don't know if we do it every time, but yeah, let's just have a look into the documentation. HTML5 file system. I want to see an example. No example here. Window request file system. Yeah, actually, I would like to see an example. No example here. I think I know. I believe I know where. What web can do today they have an example. I know that. File access. That's to check if it is not supported, but how is this being used? So they have this function here, write file. Ah, okay, just like this. I think we should debounce this if we do it like that. Now it seems that we that autosave. I think autosave is something for another time. I think we will need something like a save button somewhere. I will just put it in between here. Let's create a button. Of type button. And let's name it save. For now. I will implement the method for that. Okay. As soon as, yeah, let's implement a state when this thing is saving, set is saving, initially should be false, so, and we will disable it if it is saving. So, and as soon as we set the save click, we will set the saving to true. Let's try this out one time. So we cannot click it anymore. Okay. Good. And for now we will adjust. Yeah, we can do something like that. If we don't support this, yeah, actually, I don't want to. Yeah, well, we can do it like that for now. Oh, that's weird. It's not supported. But it told me that it is. Ah, because this needs to be HTTPS, I guess. Let's check. Is this still working? No, doesn't work anymore. We can only read files. That's bad. Then I have to definitely have to think about something else. If this only can read files. I think isomorphic git. That seems to be the way to go. So like in a browser. What is lightning file system? Seems as we are able to create a virtual file system in a browser, but I guess this is something for the next session, so I will close this one now.